Hi guys, this is Sadek from dwebin.com, and in this video, we'll show you how to take a backup of the persist partition using the ADB commands. So as soon as you step into the custom development and try out a few tweaks and tricks, such as flashing custom binaries or modules, before that, you should always take a backup of at least two partitions. The first is the persist partition and the second is the EFS partition. The persist partition holds the data for the fingerprint, whereas EFS partition has the data of the IMEI number. Apart from that, if all the other partition gets corrupted, it's not a cause of concern. You must simply reflash the stock firmware and the partition will be up and running. But in case of persist and EFS partition, if they get corrupted, then you might face quite a lot of issues. For instance, in case of the persist partition, the fingerprint will not work if it get corrupted, and you will then have to go to the service center to get it rectified, and they will charge quite a lot of money. So always make sure to backup at least these two partitions. In case of EFS, it houses the IMEI number. In case EFS partition gets corrupted, you will get either null or 00 in the IMEI number, and there is no other way out to rectify this issue. You might again have to go to service center to fix that issue, and they will again charge quite a lot of money. So always keep in mind to at least have a backup of these two partitions. Regarding the backup, there exist two methods. You may either do so via ADB command or the custom recovery like TWRP. As of now, I'll show you the ADB command first, and then I'll show you the recovery method as well. The recovery method is not usually used because most of the Android phone nowadays does not have a custom recovery, whereas using the ADB command, this method will be applicable across all the Android phone because all the phones support this recovery. But keep in mind that irrespective of the method you choose for, whether it's the ADB command or the recovery method, you will have to root your phone via Magisk. If you don't root it, then you will not be able to take a backup. So with that said, please take a backup of all the data on your phone, and then let's get started. As of now, let me show you the ADB command method. So for that, you have to root your phone via Magisk. Regarding the root, if your phone came with Android 12 or older version, then you have to patch and flash the boot IMG file. On the other hand, if it came with Android 13 or higher version, then you have to patch and flash the init boot IMG file. So carry out this task using the guide and the video given here and get this job done. Once you have obtained root, so let me show you. I have now obtained root on my phone, and this is the Magisk app. So let's now proceed ahead. Now you have to get hold of Android SDK platform tools. So get it from my guide and extract them onto your PC. You could extract them anywhere you want. In my case, I've done the extraction in C drive, and these are the files of platform tools. Once you have done the extraction, your next course of action is to enable USB debugging. This is required for ADB commands. So go to the settings menu, then go to about phones, and from there you may enable, tap on build number 7 times, and this will enable developer option. Now go to developer option and enable the toggle next to USB debugging. Let's now verify debugging connection. So go to platform tools, type in cmd in the address bar and hit enter. This will launch command prompt inside platform tools. Now type in ADB devices and make sure that you are getting an ID. If you are not getting any ID, then unplug and replug your phone from the PC. Disable and re-enable USB debugging. Tap on revoke USB debugging. Use the official USB cable that came with your phone and use the USB 2.0 port on your PC. So carry out these USB tweaks and make sure that you are getting an ID. Once you are getting this ID, your next course of action is to open the ADB shell environment and then get hold of the root access. So first off, type in ADB shell, and you will now get either your phone name or the phone code name, and after that it should show a dollar sign. If that's well and good, now type in SU and hit enter, and you should now get a prompt on your phone something like this. So make sure to tap on grant. After that, you should now get a hash sign. The dollar sign will now be replaced by the hash sign. Once that is done, we have now got the super user request, and now let's move ahead and take a backup. Now there exist two methods of backing up this partition, the automated method and the manual method. So in the automated method, you have to just use this command. So SU is the super user request, as we have already input. After that, this is the address, the block address of the persist partition. This is the name of the partition, and this is the location on your phone where the backup file will be present, and this is the name of the backup file. So as of now, the persist partition will be backed up inside the downloads folder on our phone, and it will be named as persist.img. So simply copy the entire command and paste it in the cmd window and hit enter, and as you could see, the persist img file of 32 MB has now been copied onto our phone. Let's verify the same. So open the files app, now go to downloads, and as you could see, we have now got the purchase file of 32 MB. It is highly recommended that you transfer this file onto your PC, or else there will be no use of this file because your phone will undergo a reset and then the file will be removed from your phone. So please take a backup and transfer it onto your PC. With this was the first method of getting this job done. Let me now show you the next method. This is the manual method. In the manual method, again you will have to launch a CMD window inside platform tools. Once that is done, first and foremost you will have to open the shell environment and then the super user command. So type in adb shell and your phone name or the phone code name should be now shown here. Now type in su and you should now get a prompt something along the following lines. If this is the first time you are using the su command, then only you will get a prompt. From the subsequent time, you will not get any prompts. So tap on grant and make sure that you are getting the hash symbol over here. If that's well and good, now type in this command and it will now list out all the partition table on your phone. So let's type in this command and hit enter. From here, you will have to refer to the partition name, which is persist. This is the partition name, and check out its block address, which is SDA8, and the entire block address is dev block SDA8. You may copy and paste it here as well. So this is the block address for the persist partition of our phone. As you could see from here, it might be different for different phones, so please verify from your end. The SDA address might be different for you, so copy the address accordingly. Once you have copied it, you will now have to use the following command, and this is the command syntax over here. Just make sure to replace the location keyword with the actual SDA address. So in our case, the location, instead of the location and address of the file, was dev block SDA8. As you could see from here, it's the dev block SDA8. So we have to copy this location from here and paste it in place of the location keyword, and the rest of the command will be same. As of now, we are doing a backup of the persist img file inside the SD card, which is the internal storage. So now simply, in my case, it's the SD8. In your case, it might be different. So verify it from the command and then copy the command and paste it in the CMD window. So let me do that as well. Just give me a second. I'll copy this command and paste it in the CMD window and hit enter. And we have now got the file, 32 MB file of the persist img. Let me verify the same. As of now, should be in the internal storage. This is the internal storage and this is the persist img file, as you could see. So we have now got the backup file. You should now transfer the file onto your PC. It's extremely important. So guys, these were the two methods of taking a backup of the persist.img file onto your phone via the adb command. Now if you want to restore the file, always keep in mind that you should only restore the persist file of the backup that you have made on your phone. Please don't ask for the persist file from any other user, even if that user has the same device and the same OS and even the same build number. Then also you should not ask for the persist file from that user, because that will end up making the matter only worse. Always use your own persist file. If that is not the case, if you don't have the file, then please don't flash the file of any other user, because it will further complicate the matter. So guys, now let's restore this partition. So for that, first and foremost, you will have to transfer the file inside the platform folder on your PC. So copy the file from here, let me do so, and then paste the file inside platform tools. Once that is done, now open the CMD window inside platform tools, type in CMD and hit enter. Now you have to boot your phone to the fast boot mode. So for that, type in adb reboot bootloader and hit enter, and your phone will now reboot into fast boot mode. It will take just a few seconds. Once that happens, you will now have to type in fast boot devices and make sure that you are getting a serial ID. Let's just wait, and if you are not getting any ID, then you will have to install fast boot drivers. I have made a separate guide and a video on the same. You could refer to my guide and the video and get this job done. Once you have installed the drivers, right click on the Windows icon and choose device manager. Then expand the Android phone section and make sure that your phone is being shown as Android bootloader interface. So this, as well as the serial ID next to fastboot, signify that your PC is able to read the phone in fastboot mode, and we are now good to go ahead. So now just type in fastboot flash persist and the file name persist.img and hit enter. this is a firewall flash. The command that you are already aware, this is the partition name persist, and this is the file name. Hit enter and the file will now be flashed onto your phone. Once the file has been flashed, you may type in the fastboot reboot command and your phone will boot to the OS. If that does not happen, you may simply hit the power key once, and with this your phone should now boot to the OS and the fingerprint issue should now be rectified. And apart from that, you may also get this job done using a custom recovery like PWRP, Orange Fox or Pitch Black. So let me now show you that method as well. So there are quite a few issues with that method. First and foremost, not every phone has a custom recovery. Moreover, if your internal storage is encrypted, then the recovery might not be able to make a backup of those partition. Still, let me show you the rules how you could get this job done. So for that, let me just wait for a few more seconds for my phone to boot to the OS. And since our phone is currently obtained root via Magisk, you may either boot your phone to the recovery via quite a few methods. The easiest method is using the Magisk app. So launch the Magisk app, tap on the reboot icon and choose recovery. So just choose recovery from here and your phone will boot to the recovery. But if your phone is not rooted via Magisk, then simply enable USB debugging as I've explained you earlier, and then type in the command adb reboot recovery and your phone will now reboot to the recovery mode. This command is universal across all the Android phone. And with that said, if your phone does not have a custom recovery installed, then you may refer to my guide and install the recovery as well. Let me show you my guide and the video. So if you have a recovery installed, well and good, but if you don't have a recovery installed onto your phone, then you may refer to my guide. Just give me a minute. So this is my guide, and in this guide I have explained all the various methods through which you could install the recovery file onto your phone. So if your phone has a recovery partition, you may directly flash the IMG file in the recovery partition. If it does not have a recovery partition, then first you will have to boot your phone to the recovery and then flash the recovery zip file or flash the recovery IMG file in the RAM disk partition. On the other hand, for Samsung phones, you will have to flash the recovery.tar file in the AP slot and the BBMeta file in the data slot, and then hit the flash button. Let me show you. Upload the recovery here and then upload the BBMeta file in the data slot and boot your phone to download mode and then click on start and the recovery will be flashed. I have made a separate guide for the Samsung phones as well, so you may refer to my guide and install the recovery. Once you have installed the recovery, simply go to backup and now choose the EFS, or rather the persist backup from here. Checkmark the persist partition and swipe to backup, and it will then do a backup of the persist partition. So once the backup has been made, the backup will be there inside the PWRP folder on your phone. So this is the folder PWRP. It will be there in the internal storage. So let me show you the SD card. So as of now, my data is encrypted, so I will not be able to show you. But on your phone internal storage, there will be a folder name as CWRP. The backup will be there. So copy the backup file from there and place it inside the on your PC, just to be on the safer side. So again, I'm repeating, just go to backup, choose the persist partition and do a rise up to flash it, and it will now be backed up on the TWRP folder on your phone. Once the backup is done, you may then transfer the file onto your PC, just to be on the safer side. So as of now, since my data partition is encrypted, I will not be able to take a backup, and that is why it's always a much better approach to have the adb command, because in case of recovery, sometimes things might not work out as you want. That is why it's always recommended to use the adb method. And with this, our task stands complete. So guys, on that note, I round up this video. Just to recall, you may take a backup via the adb commands as well as the recovery. For the adb command, there exist two methods, the automated and the manual. In the automated method, you just have to copy this entire command from here and paste it in the cmd window. The backup will be there inside the downloads folder on your phone. On the other hand, in the manual method, you will first and foremost have to use this command and then get hold of the address of the persist partition. After that, use this command syntax and change the location with the address of the persist partition, and then the backup file will be placed inside the internal storage. Apart from that, you may also take a backup via the Android feature of the TWRP recovery. So boot your phone to the recovery, then go to backup, and once you are inside the backup folder, choose the persist partition and do a rise up to back it. The backup will then be done and the backup file will be there inside the PWRP folder on your phone. as of now, since my partition is encrypted, I am not able to use this. So this is an ongoing issue with various Samsung phone, that the recovery is unable to decrypt the storage on the stock firmware. Until and unless I go on a custom ROM, the storage will not be decrypted. Even if I do a format data, the storage will get decrypted, but upon a next reboot, the storage will again get encrypted. That is why I am not using a custom recovery. Instead, I am using the ADB command. With that said, you are free to use both of these methods. So guys, if you have any queries with regard to any of the steps, do let me know in the comment section, and thanks a lot for watching.